Okay, today's lesson we're going to be talking about proving angle pair relationships. So before we do that, we need to know some theorems. The first theorem that we're going to discuss is the right angle congruence theorem, and it's really straightforward. It just says all right angles are congruent. So, for instance, if I was doing like a little proof that involves something like this, I would say angle A and angle B are right angles. I would have to say that before I can use this theorem. In this case, it's given in my figure. And so now that I've said that they are right angles, I could then say that angle A is congruent to angle B, and my reason would be all right angles are congruent. So that's how that one might show up in a proof. The next one we're going to talk about is the congruent supplements theorem. The congruent supplements theorem says if two angles are supplementary to the same angle or congruent angles, then they are congruent. And so if you stop and you think about it, it makes sense that if 1 and 2 add up to 180, and 1 and 3 add up to 180, then since they're both supplementary, both 2 and 3 are supplementary to angle 1, so they would have to be supplementary to each other. And so how that might look like in a proof is you would have to state that angle 1 and angle 2 are supplementary, and you would have to state that angle 1 and angle 3 are supplementary. And that would be given to you, or perhaps there would have been another way that you got to that conclusion. But anyway, once you have said that in a proof, you can then conclude that angle 3 is congruent to angle 2 by the congruent supplements theorem. All right, and then there's a very similar one called the congruent complements theorem. It's almost the same. It just says if two angles are complementary to the same angle or congruent angles, then they are congruent. So if two angles are complementary to the same angle or congruent angles, then they are congruent. Okay, so I would have to be given that angle 1 and angle 2 are complementary. As well as angle 2 and angle 3. So that would have to be given to me. And so because 1 and 3 are both complementary to angle 2, I know that angle 1 has to be congruent to angle 3. And in this case, it would be the congruent complements theorem. And so again, that's how it might look in a proof. So we're going to prove the congruent supplements theorem. And so previously I had mentioned that the given comes from your if. So if we look back at our congruent supplements theorem, the if portion says if two angles are supplementary to the same angle. And if I look back here, instead of just saying two angles are supplementary to the same angle, I've given a specific situation where 1 and 2 are supplementary and 3 and 2 are supplementary. So the hypothesis gives it to me in a general sense, but then I draw a specific example for my proof. And then the then part says they are congruent. And so angle 1 is congruent to angle 3 would be the specific case here that I'm trying to prove. All right, so like we said on the previous slide, if 1 and 2 add up to 180 and 3 and 2 add up to 180, then it only makes sense that since they're both having 2 added to them, that they would have to be equal to each other. So I'm going to start off with the information that they gave me. So step 1 would be angle 1 and 2 are supplementary. And angle 3 and angle 2 are supplementary. That was given. Now, I cannot use the congruent supplements theorem to prove the congruent supplements theorem. I can only use other theorems, facts, definitions, and so on. So, what does it mean to be supplementary? Stop and think, okay, why did they give me that information? What's it mean to be supplementary? Well, what it means to be supplementary is that their measures add up to 180. So specifically, the measure of angle 1 plus the measure of angle 2 is going to equal 180. And the measure of angle 3 plus the measure of angle 2 is going to equal 180. How do I know that? Well, that's what it means to be supplementary. It is the definition of supplementary angles. All right. Now, if they're both equal to 180, then that means that they equal each other. And so I can say that next. I can say that the measure of angle 1 plus the measure of angle 2 equals the measure of angle 3 plus the measure of angle 2. So all I did was I substituted. Instead of writing 180, I wrote the measure of 3 plus the measure of 2. So that would be the substitution property of equality. Okay, substitution can only be used when we're dealing with equations. We're not going to use substitution when we're dealing with congruence. So, just a little note there. All right, so now I'm almost to having 1 and 3 equal to each other. I notice that I've got a measure of angle 2 on both sides that I can subtract. So if I subtract the measure of angle 2 from both sides, then I'm left with the measure of angle 1 is equal to the measure of angle 3. I used the subtraction property of equality to do that. Okay, now I'm trying to prove that angle 1 is congruent to angle 3. I'm almost there, but my last statement does not yet match what I'm trying to prove. Well, if the measures are equal, then that means that the angles would have to be congruent. And so angle 1 would be congruent to angle 3. How did I know that? Well, that's what it means to be congruent. It's the definition of congruent angles. All right, so a couple other theorems we need to talk about. Oh, by the way, now that we have proved this, we can use the congruent supplement theorem. And so you don't have to go through all these steps. Once you have two angles that are supplementary, you can skip right to those angles being congruent. Okay, so vertical angle congruence theorem. Vertical angles are congruent. And we've already talked about that, but now it's officially a theorem. So I can say that angle 5 is congruent to angle 6, and I could also say angle 4 is congruent to angle 7, and my reason would be the vertical angles theorem. So vertical angles congruence theorem. And if you can't remember the name of it, you can always just write the theorem itself. So you could also just write vertical angles are congruent And I'm okay with you guys using abbreviations as long as I can tell what the abbreviation means. Now, if you just write vertical angles and nothing else, that is not enough. Okay, I need you to tell me that vertical angles are congruent. All right, and the next one is the linear pair postulate. And it simply states that linear pairs are supplementary. So in a proof, you could state that angle 1 and angle 2 are supplementary. And your reason would be the linear pair postulate. Or you could just say linear pairs are supplementary. Again, if you don't remember if it's a postulate or a theorem or whatever, just say what you know. Linear pairs are supplementary. This is another one where if you just say linear pairs and nothing else, that's not enough information. Okay, so you need to either say the linear pair postulate or linear pairs are supplementary. So now we are going to prove the vertical angles congruence theorem. So if you are given vertical angles, then they're congruent. That would be the if-then form of it. And so for the given, we have vertical angles, and we're going to prove that they're congruent. So we're given that 5 and 7 are vertical angles, and we're going to prove that angle 5 is congruent to angle 7. Now, I cannot use the vertical angles congruence theorem because that's what I'm proving. But we already proved the congruent supplements theorem, so I can certainly use that. 5 and 6 are a linear pair, therefore they are supplementary. 6 and 7 are a linear pair, so they're going to be supplementary. So 5 and 7 are both supplementary to angle 6, so they would have to be congruent. So that's what we're going to use to prove it. So of course we start off with what we're given. Angle 5 and angle 7 are vertical angles. That was given. And then, as we said, 5 and 6 are a linear pair. And also 6 and 7 are a linear pair. How did I know that? It was in the picture. It was given in the figure. All right. So if they're a linear pair, by the linear pair postulate, I know that means that they are supplementary. So angle 5 and angle 6 are supplementary. And angle 6 and angle 7 are also supplementary. And again, we knew that by the linear pair postulate. And so now that I've said that 5 and 7 are supplementary to the same angle, I know that they have to be congruent to each other by the congruent supplements theorem. And that concludes this video.